Good morning and welcome to the day 10 of our 21 day prayer and devotion. We began this week talking about asking God to stretch our imagination. I challenged you yesterday to stretch your faith in this new season. Expect God to greater things, God to do greater things in your life. Ask God for greater things regarding your job, regarding your financial situation, regarding your family, relationships. We asked you through the word of God that we, if we can believe by faith, God is infinitely able to do more than what we can ask for and even think of. The thing is, while it is easier for us to challenge you to stretch yourself to new territories and stretch your faith, sometimes we find it difficult. You see, waiting for something to happen in our lives can sometimes suck life out of us. Imagine, waiting is not usually a fun experience for us. It could be in the grocery line, it could be sitting at the doctor's office waiting to see doctor, or it could be a difficult period at work or school. You kind of find it difficult to wait for a longer time and allow your faith to be stretched at that time, or begin to believe much bigger things for our lives, or even begin to believe in promises of God. So for us, people like us who are finding it tough, first of all, even to wait on the promises that God gave us, and then stretch our faith for greater things, for people like us, Paul encourages us using Abraham's example in Romans chapter 4, verses 20 onwards. He did not waver in unbelief at God's promise, but was strengthened in his faith and gave glory to God, because he was fully convinced that what he had promised, he was also able to perform. Therefore, it was credited to him for righteousness. Abraham, as we look at this today's words, we see Abraham in such a situation. Some of us may be finding ourselves in that situation, that we received a promise or we asked God for greater things, and it's just that it's not really happening. He received a great promise from God, but for years, he did not see even a shadow of possibility of that promise being fulfilled. Abraham was an ordinary man like you and me, just like us. He faced doubts, he faced questions. He could have even forgotten God's promise because of what's happening in his life. However, this verse tells us that Abraham's faith endured. In fact, it even grew stronger. Amazing, right? It's just amazing. Abraham's faith grew because it was based on the implicit trust in the character and person of God. That, I think, is the secret. Therefore, he was able to believe and believe again and believe again that God would do what he said he would do. You see, this is where I've realized that asking God for greater things is one thing. Asking God to stretch our faith is another thing. But I've realized that our faith, as it is being stretched, cannot endure without a new revelation of God in our lives. That should be our prayer this morning. Today, as we draw close to God, ask for a revelation of his character, his greatness, his goodness to us again. You see, as we gain a deeper understanding of God, the God of promise, of our promise, our faith will be stirred up and it grows. You see, for example, I've always believed in the ability of God to heal people. But I have not seen God use me to heal anyone before. But years passed by, and as I began to pastor more and more, and began I began to have more and more revelation of God and his goodness in my life, I saw how God used my simple prayers to bring quick healings to others. Now, I'm not saying I have a gift of healing, but my faith is stretched enough by the revelation of God that I can actually pray for people who are sick, and I can actually see God bringing healing to them. So we don't have to have a specific gift in the sense of gift of healing, but if you have faith, God uses your life to do greater things than you could imagine. That's what I mean, to have a revelation of God in order to stretch your faith. You see, James chapter 2 verses 17 says that faith alone, faith is not alive until we act on God's word to us. So it's not enough to have faith in God. It's important for us to act on what we believe in God. But unless we have a revelation of God, a new revelation of God, we can't take more steps forward, faith steps forward, and stretch ourselves into new territories. I pray that today you would seek for a new revelation from God. As you ask Him for new territories to conquer, ask for a new revelation of God so that your faith can increase in this wonderful God who is calling you to ask Him anything. God bless you.